Today we're going to be taking a look at the new Cactus Jack Air Jordan 6s in the British khaki colorway. As you all know, the Air Jordan 6 is my favorite model and I am excited to unbox these things and review these for you. So let's go ahead and get into the video. Welcome back to the channel. What's up with you guys? How you doing? How you been? If you did not know by now, my name is DJ and this is The DNA Show. Now, if you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Don't forget to hit the bell notification for every time I upload a new video. And make sure you hit that like button because that helps the algorithm oh so much. Before we get started with the review, one shoe that I will be using in today's comparison is going to be the original Travis Scott Air Jordan 6 that came out back in 2019. Starting with the box, you have your classic Air Jordan 6 box that we get all the time, except for it has a major twist with the khaki colorways on it. You got a khaki top with the infrared Jumpman here on the center, Cactus Jack vibes here on the sides, and then the Cactus Jack face and the Jumpman on the front end of the box. Reading the size tag, it says Air Jordan 6 Retro SP, British khaki, bright crimson. Retail, $250. Flipping open the box, you have a bag. Starts with the bag, okay, I'm digging this. You got the little bag that I would probably never end up using for anything, but it's always dope to have another accessory with the sneakers. So on one side of the bag, you have your Cactus Jack vibes, and on the other side of the bag, you have your Jumpman vibes. And this is your regular string backpack that people would use for, you know, when you get it at free events or when you go to different places and they're always handing out those little gifts, what do they call it, swag bags, stuff like that. So I think it's a good addition to have it with the shoes. Maybe if you're traveling and you want to put the shoes inside the bag and then put that inside your suitcase or something to try to protect the shoes. So I get it, I appreciate it, but that's something that I probably would never use. Let me know what you think about the bag down below in the comment section. Now going to the paper, you have another tan paper right here, giving you those vintage vibes. And then you got the white paper, and then you got the shoe. Oh, you got the shoe. So before we get started, we gotta talk about the release. These did come out at a bunch of different places and on Sneakers app. A lot of people took their cracks at them, and I tried to get them as well, and I struck out. I was out in Aruba at the time, and I couldn't go to any other stores because there just weren't any around me. But I got lucky, and I saw that Soul Steals was doing a drop on these, and I got a pair from there. And if you haven't heard about Soul Steals, I'm telling you right now, it is a great place to be. I have the link for them down below in the description as well if you wanna check them out. But basically, it's like a membership. You subscribe to them and then they give you sneakers at a good deal, lower than the market value, and you're able to always save a couple bucks every time you're buying a pair of shoes. They do a bunch of different drops every single Sunday. They're always restocking the website with a bunch of new stuff, and then they'll get something like this, Off-White 5s, you know, Travis Scott's, Unions, whatever it may be, a lot of stuff in bulk, and then they'll do a bulk drop or release to everybody on the website, and then you can try to get them on there as well. So there's a bunch of different dope options with their website and their app, so make sure you check them out, because I'm telling you right now, Soul Steals came through in the clutch for this one. So now it's time to review the shoe and see what this thing is talking about. Starting with the outsole, you have your classic Air Jordan 6 outsole with the infrared Jumpman on the center. It's kind of translucent and it glows in the dark, which is a super dope hit to the shoe. You got your Travis Scott branding right here in black with the Cactus Jack face right here in the center of the foot, and then your Cactus Jack branding here at the toe of the foot as well. Working our way up to the midsole, you have your khaki vibes with the white teeth here at the back and the front end of the shoe, infrared air bubble, and going to the inside of the midsole, you have a Cactus Jack face here on both of the midsoles of the shoe, as you can see right here with the white branding. Definitely a nice little dope touch to the sneaker. Another dope aspect of this sneaker is they changed up the materials from what we saw on the green version and gave us something a little bit different with a more of a hairier suede version on this sneaker. And Jordan brand has always been known for, you know, the basic, you know, red, black, white, blue, black, white, purple, different things like that. So I think this is a nice switch up and definitely a great addition to the collection if you are able to get your hands on these. So as I feel the materials, you can definitely see your stroke of the finger, a nice hairy suede on there. You have your side pocket here, and then you have a zip side pocket here on this one. Looking at the tongue of the shoe, you have a nice darker brown mesh material, and then the khaki laces that come standard with the shoe. You got three more glow in the dark hits on this sneaker with the back tab, the tongue, and the little lace lock right here. So I think to add all these additions to the sneaker with more variation and more glow in the dark touches, I definitely think these have just a little bit more of an edge when it comes to the creativity level compared to the green version. Looking at the sock liner, you have the same materials as on the tongue, and that's something that I'm not sure how I'm gonna feel about, simply because it's so stiff. It may feel better when it gets on foot and you're rocking and everything like that, but just to the touch, it's definitely a very stiff material. Another dope hit that I really like is they have the Cactus Jack branding here on the lace lock with the Jumpman on the other side, and then they added the Cactus Jack here on the side of the tongue as well. If you can see it, I'll make sure I get a close-up shot for you guys. looking on the inside right here, we have one, two extra pairs of laces. So you got like an infrared color, a darker brown, and a khaki color here for the sneaker. Looking at the insoles, you have a dark brown insole with the infrared Nike Air on the right foot and a Cactus Jack branding on the left foot. And opposite of the insoles, on the left foot with the Cactus Jack, you have a Nike Air on the back end of the shoe. And on the right foot with the Nike Air, you have a Cactus Jack on the back end of the shoe. Always dope to see the Nike Air, especially with the Cactus Jack branding, and I definitely love this hit of the sneaker. So overall, this is definitely a dope shoe, and I'm excited to have these in my collection. I want to get a second pair, that way I can beat up a pair and have another pair sitting on ice. But again, I'm happy to have one because at first, I didn't think I was gonna get them. So again, shout out to Soul Steals, bro. They came in the clutch. So let's talk opinions with other people and prices and see what everybody else is talking about. If you haven't already, make sure you follow me on IG so you can participate in the polls and see the results here on the videos. So when I asked the people if this shoe was fire or trash, this is what they said. 84% of the people chose fire and 16% of the people chose trash. I can definitely understand the poll because I mean, bruh, like this is a fire shoe. It's unique. Definitely something different, and it's Travis Scott. You know, basically everything Travis Scott, everybody wants it. Okay, so now let's talk about numbers because everybody always has that question when it comes to this shoe, especially a lot of people that missed out on the sneaker. They're gonna say,
when should I buy this shoe if I really want to get it? If I gotta pay resale, how much should I pay?
Because I understand, not everybody can get all the shoes, and then they want to find it for a good deal, because as we've seen on other Travis Scotts before, you get it at that sweet spot, and then next thing you know, you give it some more time, and it starts to go up crazy. Remember, people were buying the Travis Scott 4s for like $300, now they're like $1,000. People are buying the 6s for like $400. Now they're like $700-$800, and they might be $1,000 someday. It happens to each and every one of the shoes, and I definitely think the same thing is gonna happen with these. So initially when this shoe came out, they were going for like $1,200, and I thought that was insane at the time, but I do think that this shoe could be worth $1,200 someday. Maybe some years from now, but I definitely think it could hit that $1,000 or $1,200 mark sometime down in the future. Closer to the release, the shoe started to go for around $900, which was still way too much right after the release. Then by the release time, the shoe was going for like $700 on the release day. And at that time I knew, I was like, bro, I ain't spending $700 on this shoe because I know for a fact I could get it for cheaper. And you could too. So like I told a lot of people that were asking me in that moment, be patient, the shoe is going to go down in value. And just like I said, the sneaker ended up going down in value just a couple weeks later, and now it's going for around $500. The sneaker was $250 retail, so that is double the retail value. But at the same time, if you look at the big picture, these are definitely gonna be worth more than that in the long haul. But one thing that I can also say is if you give it a little bit more time, you might be able to get these for a little bit cheaper than that, somewhere in the $400 range. And I think that is very, very possible and very realistic. So if you can, be patient, try to find a good deal. Don't go out and just pull the trigger, because I promise you, you'll be able to find these for a solid price. And then eventually the shoe is going to go up in value and you're gonna say,
man, I missed that wave. I should have bought them when they was $450, or I should have spent that $480 or $500.
And you were trying to finagle it down $20 more and you passed up on the deal. And the next thing you know, the shoe is an $800, $900 shoe. So just think about how long you wanna have this shoe in the long haul and how much you really wanna pay. And if you can afford to make that purchase, go ahead and make that purchase. And if you can't, that's completely fine too. Pass it up, chalk it up, go ahead and buy another shoe. Maybe you'll get some trade bait down the line and you'll be able to trade for it and get it later, a couple years later or something like that. Shoes come and go every single day. There's so many different releases happening throughout the week, on the weekends, all this type of stuff. Plus all the old releases, bruh, you'll be fine if you missed it. Trust me, you'll get them one day. Don't worry about it. And if you did end up getting the shoe, how much did you pay for the shoe? Did you get it for retail? Did you pay resale? Did you pay too much? Did you get it for a good deal under the resale market? I would love to hear what you guys have to say about the sneaker and your predictions on this shoe as well. And if you guys want to see a full in-depth review of these two sneakers right here, let me know down below in the comment section, because there are definitely a lot of differences, a couple similarities, but there's a lot to talk about when it comes to these two shoes. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope this was helpful. I am excited to have these shoes, bro. Super, super dope. I'll see you guys in another video. All right, y'all, I'm out. Yo, if you enjoyed this video and you want to make extra money or grow your shoe collection, I want to give you a free video with my three tips that were the most powerful that will help you grow your sneaker collection and make an additional $1,000 to $10,000 a month. All you need to do to get this free video is click on the first link in the description or the comment that's pinned in the comment section. That'll take you to a page where you can enter your email address, and I'll make sure that I send you a video right away. And if you enjoyed this video, again, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. My name is DJ. I'm signing out.
I gots to go. I'm gone.
Peace.